Hello, and welcome to Tech Talk. I'm Joy Macknight, technology editor at the bank here, and I'm here with Matthew Hodgson, CEO of Mosaic Smart Data, a data analytics vendor. Matthew, thank you so much for joining us today. Can you tell us a little bit about Mosaic and what you're offering to the banks?
Joy, we've entered a period in financial history where banks are being challenged with new technologies, and having worked within fixed income for 22 years, I experienced firsthand some of the challenges that regard around data analytics, most particularly the fact that banks struggle to deal with this overwhelming complexity of the environment that they're faced with. And Mosaic is a platform designed to handle the aggregation, standardization, and the deep analytics that banks and frontline employees within banks require for a much more granular understanding around their business.
And so you touched a little bit about the challenges that banks are facing in fixed income. Can you go into a bit more detail?
Sure. Well, within the fixed income environment, there's been enormous downward pressure on revenues. In fact, if you look at the kind of performance that the largest global investment banks have been suffering, there's been a 45% decline in fixed income revenues between when the financial crisis started in 2013, and that's expected to continue. On top of that, there's also really a huge demand for productivity gains within the front office environment. And with that, really, what we're seeing is that the demand for productivity tools is really at its peak. Moreover, banks are suffering downward pressure on their balance sheets. In fact, if you look at what Oliver Wyman is saying, that there's expected another 15% decline in balance sheet available for investment banks. So within that environment, there's clearly the demand for new technologies that add productivity to the individual at the front line, for them to be able to interact with their trading environment within their client performance, particularly as a key area that they haven't ever had before. So what we are focused on is looking at the aggregation, the standardization, and the analytics for banks, but also the application of predictive analytics, because this is obviously a very key area where parallel industries are employing this, most particularly in social media and in online retail, but we haven't really seen it coming to bear within banks.
Can you go into a bit more detail about predictive analytics as well? Because there's been a huge amount of talk around it. Maybe you can give us a bit more idea how that's being used.
Well, sure. No, within the predictive analytics space, I mean, it's obviously the cutting edge within the technology sphere at the moment. And there's been so much talk about it, but actually the application of it and how one actually looks to employ and really create value around the predictive analytics space. The way we see it at Mosaic Smart Data is that employing predictive analytics, once you have that aggregate and standardized view of your data, becomes a lot more of a coherent framework which you can work within. So within our environment, for instance, we have a consolidated view across all client performance analytics, and that's really for diagnostics, it's for client flow performance understanding, and really to be able to capture and understand the environment that the bank is actually now being faced with, because obviously as you're migrating from those over-the-counter or OTC to electronic channels, the impact is that there's now an overwhelming amount of data. And within that, really, what is it that the individual needs to be doing? And for us, we focus on the key drivers of the business, and that's namely profitability around client performance, as well as market share. So the objective is really to say we need to now segment our clients in a far more coherent way than we've ever done before, because banks don't have the capacity and the latitude with the balance sheet that they did in the past. And so now it's far more about targeting the clients that actually matter to you most.
What is your viewpoint for, let's say, 2016? How are you going to develop your business?
Well, if you look at the fintech environment, I mean, it's an incredibly congested space. And when you look at the data analytics sphere, when vendors that are looking to employ analytics within the banking space, where they don't understand the actual atomic desire of understanding that the user requires, essentially, having worked within banking for 22 years and having enjoyed, or at least, shall I say, struggled with some of the challenges that we faced, it was pretty clear that a company such as ours was necessary. In fact, I went out during my last place of employment at a large global investment bank and looked to find a company such as ours, which didn't exist. So it became pretty obvious that this was an opportunity that needed to be filled, and so that's what we're doing.
Excellent. Thank you so much for coming today, Matthew.
Thank you.